In this video, we develop the standard method of adding vectors in two dimensions. We start from the fact that vectors add head to tail, and I'll post a link real quick to the video where that was motivated. What we mean by head to tail vector addition is we take the tail of the second vector and attach it to the head of the first. Then the vector sum is a vector pointing from the tail of the first to the head of the second. So how do we handle this quantitatively? One way to do it is by using the law of cosines, but that's hard. The easy way is to start by decomposing each vector into its components, like this. And I'll post a link to the video where vector components were introduced. So the vector v plus w can be represented as a sum, vx plus vy plus wx plus wy. And these four vector components are all being added head to tail in the correct way. And we draw a vector from the beginning of the first to the end of the last vector component, and we get the same exact sum, v plus w. But here's the point. Vector addition is commutative, and that means we could take that wx and shift it down and just put it on the head of vx. And we can take that vy and attach it to the head of wx. And I'll just go ahead and cross out the ones that we moved. And so by rearranging the order of the vector addition this way, I'm thinking of v plus w as vx plus wx plus vy plus wy. And the reason this matters is that these two vectors that we start with are collinear. They point in exactly the same direction. And that means their magnitudes simply add. That allows us to actually put a number on the x component of the vector sum. Same thing in the y direction. And we have a number for the total y component of the vector sum. And at this point, we have a right triangle where the horizontal leg is the x component of the vector sum. The vertical leg is the y component of the vector sum. And we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the magnitude of the vector sum, and we can use an inverse tangent to find the angle. So to summarize our vector addition recipe, we break all the vectors into x and y components, we add up the x components and y components separately, and then we use trig to figure out the magnitude and direction of the vector sum. And like most things, it all becomes clear after we work a couple examples. So we have two examples prepared. And they both have the same instructions. Two vectors, v and w, are defined below. Compute the vector sum in polar form. And we're going to use the symbol u for the vector sum because it's convenient to have a name for it. So in the first one, we have two vectors that are pretty similar to the ones that were on the last slide. And we can qualitatively visualize the vector sum by transporting that vector w, attaching it to the head of the vector v, and then drawing a vector that goes from the tail of the first to the head of the second. And that's the vector u. If you're curious, these happen to be force vectors, so they have units of newtons on them. Of course, that doesn't change anything about the way we do the calculations. So then I proceed to get the x and y components of each of these vectors, v and w. And vx is going to be the hypotenuse, that's 12 newtons, times the cosine of 65 degrees to 3 sig figs, that gives me 5.07 newtons. So that's the rightward component of that force vector. The y component of v is 12 sine of 65, and that gives me 10.88 newtons. And we'll just keep everything to the hundredths place from here. The x component of w, that vector has a magnitude of 9 and an angle of 35, so it's going to be 9 newtons cosine 35 degrees. That gives me 7.37 newtons. And finally, the y component of w, and that's 5.16 newtons. So that's all the vector components. Again, that's the first step. And then my x components, they both point to the right, so their magnitudes simply add to each other, and I can get a total x component. And we'll call that ux. And this gives me 12.44 newtons. And the y components of these two vectors, those both point straight up. And so when I add those two components, their magnitudes simply add. And this gives me 16.04 newtons. Now I have the x and y components of the vector sum. And this gives me a simple right triangle where I know the horizontal leg and the vertical leg. What I'm trying to get at here is the hypotenuse. If I write a u with no arrow over the top, that means the magnitude of the vector sum u. And then I need the angle, and I'll call that theta. We apply the Pythagorean theorem to get the magnitude of the vector sum. And that's the square root of the sum of the squares of the legs. And we'll go ahead and round off our final answer to 3 sig figs. So this is a magnitude of 20.3 newtons. Next, we get the angle theta, and that's the angle whose tangent is 16.04 divided by 12.44. In other words, we're using an inverse tangent to get at that angle. The angle whose tangent is 16.04 over 12.44. and this gives me an angle of 52.2 degrees. The last thing we'll do in a problem like this is check for the reasonableness of our answer. So when we did the vector sum geometrically, just by shifting the vector w and attaching it to the vector v, we tried to be fairly precise about that so we could use it as a check on our work. So if I look at the magnitude, in the picture, v has a magnitude of 12 newtons here. Is it plausible that this white vector, this vector sum, has a magnitude of 20? Yeah, it looks pretty good. What about the angle? Does it look like an angle of about 52 degrees? Well, yeah, it looks a little bigger than 45 degrees, so that's plausible as well. In our next example, we have a slight complication, and the issue is that the vector v has a leftward pointing component to it, and when that combines with the rightward pointing x component of the vector w, we have to subtract the magnitudes instead of adding them. The bookkeeping method we use to keep track of this is that any leftward pointing x component gets a minus sign on it. So in this case, our vx is going to be negative 5 newtons cosine of 70 degrees, giving me a negative 1.71 newtons. In other words, 1.71 newtons pointing to the left. Vy is 4.70 newtons. Wx is 4.24. And the sine and cosine of 45 degrees are the same, so I get 4.24 newtons for the y component of w. So step one is complete, and we have all of our vector components. Just as a little sidebar here, I want to clarify why that minus sign has to be there on the x component of v. So there's vx, it's 1.71 newtons pointing to the left. And there's wx, 4.24 newtons pointing to the right. When you add these two components, head to tail, we're going to take vx and stick it on the head of w. That's my head-to-tail vector addition, and I can see that the sum of those two components is shorter than w itself. That's going to be 4.24 minus 1.71 in length. And this is why we use that minus sign on any leftward or downward pointing components. So we get our total x component. Again, that's 4.24 minus 1.71, and that gives me a total of 2.53 newtons. And we get our total y component. Those both point up, so those magnitudes add. And that gives me 8.94 newtons. Now this time I'll go ahead and visualize the right triangle in a separate picture, just to show you a stylistic difference in the approach to the problem. And our total x component is here, our total y component is here, and the vector sum points from the tail of the first to the head of the last, and that has a magnitude that we're calling lowercase u, and we have an angle of theta. And again, we run through the Pythagorean theorem. The three sig figs, this gives me 9.29 newtons. And again, our angle is the inverse tangent of the opposite over adjacent. The angle whose tangent is 8.94 divided by 2.53. This gives me 74.2 degrees. Again, before we move on, we should check for the reasonableness of our answer. So if I go back and estimate my geometric vector addition, I'm going to pick up the vector w and then attach it to the vector v, trying to keep its length and magnitude accurate. And I think that's reasonably close. And then the vector sum points from the tail of v to the head of w. And then I have to ask myself, if v has a length of 5 and w has a length of 6, is it plausible to say that this white vector u has a length of 9.3? And it looks pretty good. What about the angle, 74.2 degrees? Well, it's definitely steeper than 60 and less than 90, so that looks pretty good too. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.